compliments by sir. So I will take stop now and I will wholeheartedly welcome once again our sir, Professor Vallabh Kumar Jaisi. Jim Kumar, so I respect sir, please come over the dais and take your seat. Sir is managing partner, Warriors Hospital and Panchakarma Center, managing director, Dhatri Ayurveda Private Limited. He is also hails from a family of the traditional Ayurveda Vaidyas in Travancore and is a custodian of the curative secrets of authentic herbal medicinal preparations that have been passed from one generation to another. Dr. Sajit Kumar's hunger of knowledge and pursuit of excellence led to the full-fledged R&D center devoted to continuous research in creating products that were effective and affordable. Sir is a professional degree in the Ayurveda BMS from Trivandrum Government Ayurveda College. He has received the Best Doctor Award from Government of Kerala, Best Entrepreneur Award from the Government of Kerala. He is the Director of Care Keralam Confederation for Ayurvedic Resilience Keralam Limited, India's first Ayush cluster. He has presented various papers in the international conference, paper on the lifestyle disorders at Arab Expo, paper on growth Ayurveda in Global Ayurveda Summit 2010. He has also traveled abroad for the propagation of Ayurveda. So I once again wholeheartedly welcome Dr. S. Sajit Kumar sir. We are also having with us today's keynote speaker, Professor V.K. Joshi sir. So I please welcome you sir, please come over the dais. Introduced by the biodata as we are well-known personality in the field of Ayurveda, but I'll just tell in short, sir is presently professor in the Department of Dravya Guna at Banaras Hindu University, faculty of BHU, Institute of Ayurvedic Medicine Sciences, BHU since 2001, served as HOD of Dravya Guna for three years, and sir has published 76 papers in the various national and the international journals. He has guided 24 PhD scholars and above 24 MD scholars, about 10 PhD scholars. He is the chairman of Ayurveda Pharma.
Friends, as you know, according to Charak Sanhita, it is stated that nanoshadibhutam jagat kinchit dragdam upalabdhyate. That means the plants available in the universe are having. In the similar context, there is another verse, Sevitatya Mahabrukhya Phala Chaya Samannita Jadi Daivat Phalagunasti Chaya Kena Nivarchi. Suppose any plant having no medicinal value, then this said plant do not disgrace the human society. Rather, it provides shade to the humanity as well as it enriches the environment. So medicinal plant is the eternal part of our life from down the civilization. And as you all know, medicinal plants provide us food, shelter, clothing, and also the medicaments. So according to Charak, Chikitsa Chatuspa, so, drug, the medicinal plants are the main aspect of our life. So, Dr. Joshi, he will speak on the subject vividly. So, I mean, with all these words, I request Professor Joshi to present his remarks.
Mr. Chairman, co-chairman, on the dais, and all the dais, esteemed Professor R. Singh Ji, many of my students and friends. I was given this talk by the Congress to speak on this race name of using Sur Prasanam Dasiman. dasam imani iti dasimani. That is of the soul, about the soul plus man drugs, which is enumerated in the Charak Samhita Sutra 4th chapter. The uniqueness of that chapter is that accent-based classification is given, and 50 such groups having 10 drugs in each are enumerated. Starting from the Jivaniya, Brahmaniya, Lekhaniya, Vedaniya, Sandaniya, Deepaniya, Pachaniya, so and so on. Now see that the first gun is the Jivana or the Jivaniya gun, and last one is the Prajastha. The sequential arrangement of the Jivaniya, Brahmaniya, Lekhaniya, when you take the axis of the Jivaniya, there are all chances that you may have the Brahman or the bulk promotion. And once the bulk promotion is there, you are required the Lekhani. That is the another line of talk, but I will focus my talk on this Sul Prasavan Mahasa. This pippali pippali mool chabbi chitrak sangave marich ajmoda ajganda ajaji gandiranthi dasye mani sool prasanna. The word sool is many times misnomer. It is only considered as a pain, but it is not. Sool eva atati pidati iti sool, which have a sharp pain like the weapon piercing on your body. That is the actual meaning of this. And such elevating drugs are known as the soul prasanna. Obviously, you'd like to know the botanical source of those ten drugs. And these are the botanical source of those ten drugs. We have the classical name, left side, followed by their respective scientific or the botanical identity, which has been fixed by the Pharmacopoeia Committee also. Now, the question comes that part of that plant, those plants, these are the left side, you can see the plant, and right side that one. Regarding this pippali fruit of that pippali, it is said that it should be used after 1 year of its maturity. Gud madhu pippali vidang, after 1 year of the collection. And it has been observed that the pippali now, it contains the piperine, which is seen much after its maturity. Now this piperine is used to enhance the activity of the anti-tubercular drugs. Any drug leading to that, the dose is reduced. So pippali is one of the drug. This is the pippali mool, Piper longum. Once I had been to the Odisha, I came to know that between Bhuvaneswar and the Jagannath Puri, there is a place known as Pipali, if you know it. And the Piper longum of that area, I came to know while inquiring, passing through that the traditionally they were using this Pipali for this rejuvenation. Still, it is practiced, but it is only to the few people. This is the chabbi, jailanika. This is strangavate, gingival officinate. Now in Charak Samhita, two words have come up, ardha strangavate and the strangavate. When we talk of the ardha strangavate, it means the ardra. And strangavate means gingival officinate. Now This Sringa ware is exclusively grown in the southern part of the country, Kerala. Now this Adrak, which is the Ardha Sringa ware, if you break it, it will have fibrous bread. Whereas the Sringa ware, it has the non-fibrous. It is a brittle. Piper nigrum, marich, ajmoda, APM, leptophyllum. People confuse this drug with the APM gravulens. APM gravulens is not indigenous to India. The gravulens has come from the exotic one, but actually we have the leptophyllum. Ajaganda, thymus serpylum, which is called the vanyavani also. It's a leaf, has the same fragrance like yavani has, and it is grown in the Himalayas, not seen in the market. Ajaji, cuminum cyanum, or the jirak, well known to everybody, uses it as a household or as a spice. This is gandhi, Arogya jewelry. This is the having a beautiful flower, and if you go to the part of the southern there, even in Assam, which is planted nearby the roadside. Now this, whether Charak has used those drugs or not, or just given as a Sool Prasaman Mahakasai. These are the different kinds of the Sool has invented in Charak Samhita, with the reference of that in Chikisa Sthan. You can come across with the Yoni Sool, Sirah Sool, Gud Sool, Kost Sool, Pas Sool, Rit Sool, Basti Sool, Vakshan Sool. There are a long list of, but I have taken a few of that, which is very important in the sense of we are used, the drugs are used in such conditions. See that the, you can see that the cost. The pain is so agonizing that the patient is holding his stomach. And soon, in case of children, is expressed by the very loud cry. He cannot say that I have a pain, but the crying of, you know, one of the plant of Ajmoda, the arc is prepared of that, is very good for the, in case of the soul in children. The Sirah Soul, Asti Soul, these all are the sharp pain, and which disturbs the completely to a person. A pain, one can control it, but a colic or the sharp pain is very difficult to tolerate. This Hrithasu, you can see that the patient is trying to hold his body to combat that, and even refers to your left arm. The Sirah Sool, again, Dant Sool, Kati Sool, you can see that there's a various kinds of Sool which has been enumerated in Chikisya Sthan, Karna Sool, Guda Sool. You can see that the patient, while defecating the Sool. But all the times you cannot perform the Swedhan. You require the drugs which can perform that action. Further, the Charak has said, Svedo Agni Gun Sansay. Means this, Agni Gun is the very important to perform that Svedan action. And that Chakrapani has elaborated much more. It is of two kind. Swedo sayakto agni ekang sarvang vato istripto ruksh. In case of the vatik soul, that agni, agni go with snig is very important. In case of kafas soul, you are required this ruksh with the agni go. This has further elaborated by the Charak that Sved Svatyaha Prasamyanti Gada Vat Kafas. It means the soul has its origin either from the Vat or the Kaf located in a particular region or the Srotas or the coast. And further Charak has said that if you take a wood which is completely dry, oleate it and give a heat treatment, what happens? It becomes soft. Like that, that the agni vardrabya, if you give to a patient having the soul, then definitely that prasaman will be there. Now, further, the what are the parts of the plants, as plants which can perform this swedan? They are either from the mool, the phal, kand and patta. And you can see that the out of the dasemani mahakasai of the sun prasamar, these are the part which are written here. About the properties, you know, in Charak, I was recently searching one word about this guna, that very aphorism is given, that sarv karma guna karta, all the actions, not only of the drug, of anything in the universe, that is because of the properties. The property is responsible for any kind of the action. Here also you can see that the most of the drugs, they are katu, except Srangaveri, which is tikta also. And Srangaveri is called the Visvavesaj. Now the word Visvavesaj is elaborated many meanings, but actual meaning of that is Sarvesana Rogana Vesajam Visvavesajam. Why? Because of the Tikta Ras, it is the Aam Pachak. Aamo Visasangyaka. And Aam Pachak. That's why this particular drug is given in Aam Soup. Charak has exclusively this given this drug in Aam, Aam Janya Soup. So that Aam is anywhere. Sorry. And the one important property, if you look into the all drugs, that is the ushna in veer. None of the drug is seethi. All the drugs of the this Surya Prasanna Mahakasaya, they are ushna. And because of that, they perform this swedan action. This is very important. So whenever a patient of the soul comes to you, without any second thought, give the, those drugs. And I have my experience with the Sandhi Soul, Rith Soul. I used to prescribe this in case of Rith Soul, this your Arjut with Pippali. And it's a very good effect is seen. So it is you to decide which, what kind of combination is required. But definitely, either one of the sulps. Now, see that the Chitrak, see, Pippali mool, Deepaniya Pachini, Ana Prasamadana. Chitrak moolam, Deepaniya Pachini, Gud Sothar Sudharana. Now, it's the exclusive drug for the Gudas Sud. Take the powder of that, give it with the milk, within 2 to 3 minutes, a patient comes to having this good soul immediately. I have my experience looking this all. This even for this Vishwahesa or this Swangavi, Sasanyam Deepanam Rishcham, Ushram Vat Kapha, both Vat and Kaf Sul, if it is there, you can prescribe. And I think in every one's house, Sunti is there. It has added advantage as Aam Pacha. It's the only drugs having the tip. Again, see that this Pippali, Kaf Vatagni. And though it is Katvush, but even it is the having this Madhurupa. So usually those having this in that soul is there, the Dhatu Chai is constant soul causes the Dhatu Chai also. In such cases, Pippali, which is the having Madhurupa, that can be used. Marich, again, Kaf Vat Jit, it is said in Charat Samhita. Now this, again, I had gone to this Charak Chikitsa Sthan. There really, those drugs of the Sur Prasanna Mahakasaya are prescribed in the different suits or not. I got the references. You can see that in Chikitsa Sthan, fifth, in Yoni Sul, Pippali is prescribed, Siras Sul, Pippali is prescribed, Gud Sul, Ajmoda, Ajganda, Chitrak, Azaji is prescribed, in Kost Sul, Pars Sul, His Sul, you can see that almost all those drugs which are ascribed in the Sul Prasanna Mahakasaya, they are either alone or in combinations are prescribed. Now the question comes for a quick action, what to do? You know that these are the basic pharmaceutical forms, dosage forms, mind. We have forgotten it completely. We have moved to the another kind of preparations. But Charak has emphasized that Tesam Yathapuram Baladikyam. These all use the, you can use the powder, the kalk. Kalk is of two types, the susk or ardha. For a more quicker action, you can use the fresh one, take the kalk of that, or otherwise, if you do not have the fresh one, you can use the powder of that. So friends, that the Sula Prasanna Mahakasaya, I'll conclude that the Sula Prasanna Mahakasaya Dasemani is the original contribution of the Charak Samhita. Those drugs of the Sula Prasanna Mahakasaya are seen in Susa Samhita, 38th chapter, in Pippaliyadigar. That is very important. All the drugs of the Sula Prasanna, they are seen in the Susa Samhita also, having the similar accent. All the drugs are of Ushnavi, hot importance, which causes Swedan. And by virtue of hot potency, Vat and Kaf is antagonized. That is the Sula Prasanna Mahakasaya. With these words, I thank you all and thank you organizers for giving the award.
Chairperson sir, co-chairperson sir, and all the dignitaries in the galaxy of scholars of Ayurveda. Topic of my presentation, as you have seen, is botanical identity of classical drugs Asan and Bijak. Basically, issue of unidentified and controversial classical drugs has been a big challenge for scholars of Ayurveda. botanically different plant species are being used for the same classical drug in different parts of the country, and the same botanical plant is used by different names in different parts. So again, this plant kapal, that is classical drugs asan and bija, commonly known as bijasar, are considered to be synonymous. Here an effort has been made to address the controversy of botanical identity of classical drugs asan and bija. Aim of present study has been to address this controversy. Both are the two important classical drugs used differently in classical texts. Scholars of Ayurveda consider both the terms to be synonyms. Two different plant species, namely Terminalia tomentosa and Pterocarpus marsupium, are in use among traditional tribal healers as asan and vijayasar respectively. To address this issue, two-tier study was designed. The study included field survey and literary review of classical texts. A study survey was conducted in the forested areas of Khiri district, that is Dudhwa National Park, and Pilibhit district of Uttar Pradesh. Both the districts are situated in the Tarai region of Uttar Pradesh in the foothills of Himalayas. Major area of these two districts is covered by thick salt forests. Forested area of Khiri district is inhabited by two important tribal communities, that is namely Tharus and Bhoksas. Tharu tribes have a well-organized social order. Tribal medicine man Bharra is responsible to look after the health of the community. He works in a Bhumihar system of the traditional system. His bread and butter is looked after the community in return. So they collect herbs from the forests and use them in fresh form for healing purposes. Thus, a great system of traditional healing is still in practice in this tribal belt. So findings of the field survey were recorded using a plant utilization questionnaire. Findings were documented and analyzed. A literary survey was carried out to authenticate tribal claims. Findings of field survey, field study were critically analyzed in perspectives of Ayurveda texts. Observations of tribal system revealed use of two different plant species, namely asan, that is Terminalia tomentosa, belonging to family Cambrataceae, and vijayasar, which we in classical texts call as bija. It is Pterocarpus marsupium, belonging to family Fabaceae. In tribal medicine, decoction of bark of asan is used as a cardiotonic for the treatment of edema of cardiac origin and diarrhea. Ashes obtained by burning its stem and its branches is used as a detergent by the local people. Vijayasar, that is Pterocarpus marsupium, is used mainly for the treatment of urinary discharges and glycosuria. So, literary survey of classical drug text reveals mention of two different drugs by the name of asan and bija. In classical texts, asan has been used both as a single drug and in polyherbal formulations indicated for urticaria, orodental hygiene and rasayan, etc. Bija has been indicated for anemia, skin diseases, diseases, hair problems, rasayan, kas, rajachma, etc. Ashtangrada Uttar Tantra, both the drugs, that is asan and bija, in rasayan prakarana are used simultaneously, and this reveals that both the plants, that is asan and bija, are two different plant species, not the synonyms. References of classical medicinal uses and their comparative analysis with tribal claims shows that both the drugs asan and bija are derived from two different botanical sources. These are Terminalia tomentosa, belonging to family Cambrataceae, and Pterocarpus marsupium, belonging to family Fabaceae. From the study, it may be concluded that classical drugs asana and bijak are derived from the different plant species. Asana is Terminalia tomentosa, that is family Camelidaceae, and bijak is Pterocarpus marsupium, family Fabaceae. Consideration of asana and bijak as synonyms is not appropriate. Considering asana and bijak as different plant drugs provides us an opportunity to include a new plant, namely Terminalia tomentosa, in pharmacopoeia. It is abundantly available, that is the quality of the drug. It is being used by the tribal people by its classical name itself. And bijak is a separate plant drug, that is Pterocarpus marsupium, which belongs to family Fabaceae. At last, I would like to thank to the administration of Dudhwat National Park and Pilibhit Tiger Reserve for facilitation of this study. Dr. Kaushal Kumar, ex-ethnobotanist, NBRI Lucknow, and principal in LH State Ayurved College for their cooperation and support. And organizers of World Ayurved Congress for providing an opportunity to share this observation. And thank you. Thank you all.
Thank you, Dr. Harshankar, for your nice presentation. Now I request Dr. Anjan Isipek as Lekhanekar. Dr. Kal.
Good afternoon to all of you. My work on phytochemical analysis of bark of chirbilva collected in different seasons and its effect as Lekhan Karma. The active principle contains in plants vary at different stage of growth under different climate and ecological conditions, and particular parts of a plant are collected for using as drug in a particular season as described by several acharyas as according to Charak. That Sharadi Tvakakanda Shinani Himante Sarani Yathar Ritu Pushpam Palamiti. So according to Charak, the bark should be collected in Sharad Ritu. So the collection of particular part of a plant in particular season and bark of Chirbilva, that is Holoptilia integrifolia sample, was collected during Sharad Ritu and Grishma Ritu. And changes in chemical constituent in the bark of Chirbilva in different seasons and preceded clinical trials to study the effects of Lekhan Karma in overweight. As Charak has included Lekhan Mahakasha, Lekhaniya Mahakasha. My aims was to evaluate the changes in chemical constituents in the bark of Chirbilva collected in two different seasons, one is Sharad Ritu and second is Grishma Ritu, and to evaluate Lekhan effect of the chirbilva in overweight and to find out the impact of collection of bark in different seasons. According to phytochemical analysis, was done qualitative examination of inorganic and organic matters and quantitative examination of inorganic and organic matters, including total ash. And for clinical trials, selection of patient, overweight volunteers, BMI greater than 23 at random basis. And total number of patient was 30, 10 patient in each group. The group was divided into three, and in group one, the preparation of Ghanavati collected of bark of Chirbilva in Grishma Ritu, and in group two, Ghanavati of Chirbilva bark collected in Sharad Ritu, and group 3 was control group, that is Navagugulu, that was reference was taken from Passage Ratnavali, and the doses 2 vati twice in empty stomach and duration was 3 months. Parameters was body weight, BMI, measurements of chest, abdomen, waist, hemoglobin percent, serum cholesterol, serum triglycerides, HDL, LDL and VLDL. Inclusion criteria was men and women age between 15 to 45 years, BMI greater than 23, and extent any chronic diseases, endocrinal diseases, patients more than 45 years, after menopause in women. Discontinuation criteria was any sort of allergy caused by drug, unable to follow the trial schedule. According to the observation, qualitative analysis of tirbalavir, there were sulfur was present in both the season collected, both the season, and the iron was more present in season 2, that was Sharad Ritu, compared to the Grishma Ritu. And there was absent of heavy metals in both the season. And regarding the extraction value, in petroleum ether solvent, toluene, chloroform, ethyl acetate, and methanol, there are more extraction value comparatively to the Grishma Ritu. That means in Sharad Ritu, the extraction values are more. And regarding the ash value, total ash was more in Grishma Ritu compared to the Sharad Ritu. And in water soluble ash also, in Grishma Ritu is more than Sharad Ritu. And regarding acid insoluble as, the Sharad Ritu have acid insoluble as percentage found the more. And regarding the qualitative analysis of organic matters, carbohydrate, tannin, protein, saponin, phenol, glycosides, alkaloids are present in both the seasons, and starch was absent in both the seasons. This is the TLC in petroleum ether extract. We can see the many spots are present in T2, that was Sharad Ritu. And the second graph was shown, the HPTLC graph, that is many peaks are available in Sharad Ritu and compared to the Grishma Ritu. Here the comparatively TLC analytical study of tirbalavir, RF values are in season 2, that is Sharad Ritu, there are 5 spots was found and various RF values are given, and in Grishma Ritu only 3 spots was found. Simultaneously, after derivatization with anisaldehyde sulfuric acid reagent followed by heating 105 degrees Celsius for 15 minutes, the RF spots are, 8 spots are found in Sharad Ritu and 5 spots are found in Grishma Ritu. The highest RF value was 0.91 in Sharad Ritu and the minimum was 0.35 in both the Ritu, Sharad and Grishma Ritu. Regarding the clinical trial, in body weight percent difference is comparatively more in group 2 than group 1 and group 3. And the changes towards the normal weight according to the percentage, group 1 is 12.66%, group 2 21.99%, and in group 3 14.015%. And in serum cholesterol was decreased in group 2 and group 3. So tirbalavir ghanvati collected in Sharad Ritu as well as control drug is affected in serum cholesterol. And in serum triglyceride, tirbalavir ghanvati collected in Sharad Ritu reduced serum triglyceride level, and statistically also it was significant. So my conclusion was the phytochemical analysis concludes that the quantity of active principle is more in season 2, that is in Sharad Ritu, than Grishma Ritu. And the drug tirbalavir clearly describes in Lekhaniya Mahakashaya of Charak Samhita, it produced good result in reducing the waist measurement as compared to the weight reduction, according to my observation. And in tirbalavir ghanvati, reduced serum triglyceride level, statistically it was significant. And clinical trial concluded that the bark collected in Sharad Ritu is mentioned in Samhitas is more effective in comparison to Grishma Ritu. these are some suggestions for further studies. The drug should be used along with diet control and physical exercise for better results. For the study of seasonally changes in bark, it should be collected from the particular plant in both the seasons. And churna may be more effective than kanavati because it has more fibers found in bark of chirpilva. I would acknowledge Dr. Meeta and all the faculty members of NIA Department of Dravagun and all my seniors, my juniors, and I thank to the director of PLIM, Gaisav Ghaziabad, UP, for his support and their facility, and the passionate involvement of the team, Dr. Vijay Agnihotri, Mr. Raju Pawar, and Mr. Anil Bhatia. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Kalko, for your nice presentation. According to the different seasons, you have narrated Chirabirjo, IRT works. So I thank you again. Now I may request Dr. Bhaskar Janavar to present his paper.
On dais and my friends, my topic of presentation is exploring the xanthine oxidase inhibition potential of Chinospora cardifolia, that is Guruji. Xanthine oxidase plays a major role in purine nucleotide metabolism in humans. Its major function is to catalyze the oxidation of hypoxanthine to xanthine and xanthine to uric acid. Overproduction of uric acid leads to uremesia, which is linked to gout, which is we call it as a vata rakta. Gout is characterized by deposition of uric acid in joints, lead to severe episodic painful conditions and inflammation. The stem of Guruji is being frequently used in Ayurveda in the form of single drugs as well as in the form of polyherbal formulations for treatment of vata rakta, joint pains and related inflammatory disorders. Purpose of my study is determine whether Chinospora cardifolia extract shows the inhibition of xanthine oxidase in vitro and evaluate whether Chinospora cardifolia extract can be good herbal alternative for gout treatment as compared to commonly used xanthine oxidase inhibitor, that is allopurinol, which has its own side effects. Methods. The plant material consists of dried powder stem of Chinospora cardifolia belonging to family Minispermaceae. The dried stem material collected in and around Nanded, Maharashtra during the month of April 2014 and was authenticated by Dr. Gavai, HOD, Botany Department, Science College, Nanded, and Dr. Shirfule Amol Sir, Professor of Herbal Medicine, Science College, Nanded. Preparation of extract and fractionation. The air-dried powder stem of Chinospora cardifolia taken 100 gram was extracted with methanol and water 7:3 mixer using a mechanical shaker for 4 hours. Then the resultant extract was concentrated under reduced pressure to yield of residue. Then the hydromethanolic extract was extracted successively with equal volumes of petroleum ether, chloroform and ethyl acetate. Each fraction was concentrated under reduced pressure to obtain petroleum ether fraction, chloroform fraction, ethyl acetate fraction, and a residual fraction. In vitro xanthine oxidase inhibitory activity. All the fractions of Chinospora cardifolia were assessed for their in vitro xanthine oxidase inhibitor activity. Xanthine oxidase inhibitory activity was assessed spectrophotometrically under aerobic condition using xanthine as a substrate. The assay mixture considered of 1 ml consisted of 1 ml of fraction, 2.9 ml of phosphate buffer and 0.1 ml of xanthine oxidase enzyme solution. After pre-incubation at 25 degrees Celsius for 15 minutes, the reaction was initiated by addition of 2 ml of substrate solution. The assay mixture was incubated at 25 degrees Celsius for 30 minutes. The reaction was then stopped by addition of 1 ml of 1 normal hydrochloric acid, and the absorbance was measured at 290 nanometer using a multi-detection microplate reader. A known inhibitor of xanthine oxidase which is allopurinol, was used as a positive control. Results: inhibition of xanthine oxidase resulted in a decreased production of uric acid, which was measured spectrophotometrically. All the fraction of Tinospora cardifolia elicited a dose-dependent inhibition of xanthine oxidase fraction. That is 84.7 plus or minus 0.5% inhibition. The percentage inhibition of fat ether fraction was 78.5 plus or minus 1.6%. This was followed by chloroform 64.55 plus or minus 1.55%, and residual fraction shows 50.05 plus or minus 1.85 percentage fraction. The concentration of fractions at which 50% of xanthine oxidase inhibitory activity was calculated, that is IC50, these results were compared with the standard drug allopurinol, which showed 92.25 plus 0.05% inhibition at 100 microgram per ml concentration, with the IC50 value 6.1 plus or minus 0.3 microgram per ml. Study suggests that in preventing the progress of gout and related inflammatory conditions. Result in tabular form mentioned here, that is using PET ether ethyl acid 0.45. Conclusion: stem of Tinospora cardifolia revealed promising xanthine oxidase inhibiting potential as compared to standard drug allopurinol. Stem of Tinospora cardifolia can be a good herbal alternative for gout treatment. Acknowledgement. It is my great pleasure for me to acknowledge my thanks to my guide Dr. Amol Shirpule for their constant encouragement and guidance for entire project work at Science College Nanded, where I done MSc Herbal Medicine. I am extremely grateful to Dr. D.U. Gavi, HOD, Department of Botany and Herbal Medicine, and Dr. G.M. Kalamse, Principal Science College Nanded, for giving me the opportunity for completion of my project work in the college. I am also thankful to L.H. Kamble, School of Life Sciences, Mr. Ramanam Tirth Marathwada University Nanded, who provide infrastructure for assessment of xanthine oxidase inhibitory activity. Thank you.
My research topic is acute and subacute toxicity study on Erythrina variegata. Medicinal plants and herbal preparations have recently received considerable attention and have been found to be a promising choice over modern medicines in a number of studies. In developing countries all over the world, 80% of the population continues to use traditional medicine in primary medical problems. Erythrina variegata, belonging to the family Fabaceae, is a medium-sized dioecious small tree with prickly stems and branches, leaves with triangular leaflets and large coral red flowers. It is known that the consumption of medicinal plants without evaluating efficacy and safety can result in unaccepted or toxic effects which may affect different organs. The aim of the present study was to assess the toxicity of the ethanolic leaf extract of Erythrina variegata in male visitor rats with the following objectives: to ascertain the acute and subacute toxicity study of ethanolic leaf extract of Erythrina variegata. The leaves of Erythrina variegata were collected from the Holy Hills, Namakkal, Tamil Nadu, and they authenticated by Dr. P. Jayaraman, Director, Plant Anatomy Research Center, Chennai. The shade-dried leaves were and allowed to evaporate on water bath. This extract was dissolved in water before oral administration to the experimental rats. The experimental animals used were male visitor rats and housed in polypropylene cages at room temperature 22 with proper ventilation. Prior to experiments, animals were fed with standard diet for 1 week in order to adapt the laboratory conditions. They were fostered but allowed free access to water 16 to 18 hours prior to administration of the test dose. This work was approved by the Institutional Animal Ethical Committee of Periyar University. The statistical analysis used were SPSS 16 for widows. The acute and subacute toxicity study was performed to establish the pharmacologically effective dose of ethanolic extract of Erythrina variegata. For acute studies, rat pair fed orally with ethanolic extract of Erythrina variegata at 200 mg per kg body weight. For subacute toxicity study, 28 days, group is divided into 5 groups. And first one is normal, second is ethanolic leaf extract of Erythrina variegata at 200 mg per kg body weight. And the group 4 is 400 mg per kg body weight, and group 5 is 600 mg per kg body weight, and group 6 is 1000 mg per kg body weight. These are the parameters analyzed in the subacute toxicity study results. In the acute toxicity study, appearance is normal and the activity is present and the gait is normal. Reaction to stimulus, sound, touch and light is present medium. Lacrimination, salivation, pillow erection, stimulant, depressant, licking of paw and convulsions is absent. The results reveal that the ethanolic leaf extract of Erythrina variegata showed no mortality at 2000 mg per kg body weight. After the experimental period of acute toxicity study, the subacute toxicity study was carried out by assessing the effect of ethanolic leaf extract of Erythrina variegata on biochemical liver marker enzymes and hematological parameters. These are the effect of Erythrina variegata on relative organ weights in male Worcester rats in the subacute toxicity study. There is no significant differences was found with the control and the treatment groups. The cross examination of the internal organ of treated rats revealed no pathological abnormality as compared with those of the control. These are the results of the Erythrina variegata on hematological parameters. The results indicate that the hematological parameters such as hemoglobin, red blood cell count, white blood cell count and packed cell volume are remained within the physiological range in both control and the treated group during the experimental study. The increase in the hemoglobin level coupled with the increase in the WBC count emphasized the beneficial effect of the ethanolic extract of Erythrina variegata well-being in the rats. Assessment of hematological parameters can be used to determine the extent of deleterious effect of foreign compounds, including plant extract, on the blood constituents of an animal. These are the results on the biochemical parameters in male Worcester rats. The results indicate that the hematological parameters such as there is no significant difference in the biochemical parameters in the control and the treatment groups. The significance is fall within the reference ranges. The effect of Erythrina variegata on the serum liver marker enzymes in the control and the experimental rats. The serum levels of AST, ALT and ALP are usually elevated in conditions associated with injuries or diseases affecting the liver, which leads to the release of these hepatocellular enzymes into the bloodstream. The level of the marker enzymes of the ethanolic extract of Erythrina variegata at four different concentrations, 200, 400, 600 and 1000 mg per kg body weight, along with the control, is used to assess the subacute toxicity study induction in rats. Among the four concentrations used, 400 mg per kg body weight showed significant normalcy in marker enzyme levels than the control. These are the histological examinations of the liver sections. The histopathological examination of liver was performed in order to further confirm whether the tissue has been damaged or not. Histological examinations of the liver under the light microscope was done to observe the effect of ethanolic extract of Erythrina variegata on the structural integrity of the cells. The liver of control cells showed normal histological architecture. Group 2 to group 5, the hepatocytes were found to be normal with normal trites, central vein and hepatic sinusoids. Conclusion. In acute toxicity study, the results revealed that the ethanolic leaf extract of Erythrina variegata showed no mortality at 2000 mg per kg body weight. Subacute treatment showed that 28 days administration of ethanolic leaf extract of Erythrina variegata did not produce death or clinical signs of toxicity. Both the control and treated groups appeared uniformly healthy at the end of the experimental period. The results further indicates that the ethanolic leaf extract of Erythrina variegata can be considered as non-toxic in rats at the doses studied.
acknowledgement. I'm grateful to Periyar University for providing the laboratory facilities and funding to carry out the research work. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Shiva, your presentation. Now I may request Dr.
Chairperson, sir, co-chairperson, sir, all delegates. My topic, today's topic is Glory of Himalayan Sea Buckthorn Berry. It is in review. Introduction, Sea Buckthorn, Latin name is Hippophere Amnoides. It is belonging to the family Ilignaceae. It is most researched Himalayan plant and very few, in Ayurveda, it is only one reference I found in Bhav Prakash, in Amradi Falavaraga, Amlich, by the name Amlich. One can witness several research papers published in Index Journal pioneering role of sea buckthorn in human health care. What is most amazing fact I found, it contains about 190 bioactive compounds. Some of I quoted here, like vitamins A, D, E, K, C, B1, B2, B6, B12. Some of minerals like sodium, potassium, calcium, manganese, magnesium, zinc, etc. Flavonoids, myricetin, campanophron, etc. Fatty acids like palmitic acid, palmitoic acid, stearic acids, and mostly omega 3, 6, 9 and rarest omega 7 is found in this plant. Phospholipid like lecithin, siphanin, etc. The plant also having agronomic and environmental protection property. Sea buckthorn develops an extensive root system capable of fixing nitrogen. Thus, it is suitable for growth on marginal soils, eventually improving them to support the growth of other plants. It is quite tolerant of soil spray adjacent to highways. Sea buckthorn has been used for soil erosion control and land reclamation project, wildlife habitat enhancement and farm stand protection. It increases the soil fertility. It has several nutrition applications. It is used in juices, candies, jellies, jams, alcoholic and non-alcoholic beverages. It is used as flavoring agent in many dairy products. It can be used as food supplement such as gelatin, vegetable-based capsules, oral liquid, etc. It is also have cosmeceutic value. Many of cosmetic products nowadays contains a sea buckthorn as main ingredients. Leaves are used to protect the leaf extract, to produce the leaf extract, tea powder, and it is also used in the cosmetic. It is also used in animal feed. And in poultry, it is also used for increasing the body weight of the hens and egg production. It is a panacea for many of the diseases. Many research are carried out for proving its activity on the heart diseases, liver diseases, skin diseases, cancer, atherosclerosis. It is also having immunomodulatory, anti-stress, hepatoprotective, and many more activities. Discussion. European Journal of Clinical Nutrition discovered the berry reduces post-meal blood sugar spike in type 2 diabetes. The Journal of Nutrition Biochemistry reports the participant taking oil supplement daily over a course of 4 months experienced a significant improvement in their atopic dermatitis. Similarly, study in food and chemical toxicology found sea buckthorn oil applied topically to burn wound in rats markedly accelerates the healing of wound. Cytoprotective, anti-stress, immunomodulatory, hepatoprotective, radioprotective, anti-atherogenic, anti-tumor, antimicrobial, and tissue regeneration properties of sea buckthorn have been reported. Conclusion, sea buckthorn, Hippophere amnoides, is a versatile plant with an effective therapeutical, nutraceutical, cosmeceutical properties. It should be used by a wide range of population in India and get the benefit of it as nature has provided an amazing remedy for human being. Thank you. These are the references. Thank you.
Thank you. On this particular subject.
In fact, this is the Anuvetas of the Charak Samhita.
And there they called a receiver. In Charak Samhita, it is known as Anuvetas and has group name the Amla group of drugs. It is a very good appetizer that enhances the appetite and also expulses the gases from the stomach. And now this, the juice of this drug is marketed by the many of the companies as a, you know, a rejuvenator, the market.
Thank you, sir.
My respected co-chairman and chairman and audience, my topic is the therapeutic use of andrographis penculata. Common name is Calmate. This is a critical review in the case of growth in the cultivated land and uncultivated land. This growth is what different in this colony. This is a plant is cultivated land. Contained in introduction, taxonomical alert, morphological and microscopic leaves. Cultivation and activation, therapeutic use, other significant therapeutic use and conclusion. This is a wild stage, Kalme. Because of the some weeds, plant may be decreased the wild stage Kalme plant. So thus, in this case, this population may be reduced in the forest area. Introduction. Kalme is an annual herb belonging to family and Anthesiaceae and native in India and Sri Lanka. It is widely used in antibiotic, antibiotic and antiviral. The Thai herbal pharmacopoeia, the total electrode in the plant were determined by HD based titration. It is extremely bitter in the taste and used in treat liver disorder, bowel complaint and children, colic pain, common cold and upper respiratory tract. Like I say, upper portion may be problem, this is used. The area parts of Kalme is commonly used in the Chinese medicine. According to the Chinese medicine therapy, Kalme cool and relieves internal heat, inflammation and pain and in use the detoxification. In Kalme, we use for treating animal disease like respiratory infection and diarrhea and so on. Modern pharmacological study indicate that the endocannabinoid protect to liver and gallbladder and has been found to be slightly more active than silman, a known hypoprotective drug. Neoandrographic show greater activity against malaria and hepatoprotective against carbon tetrachloride. The herb contains dicotropinoids, flavonoids, and polyphenol and is the major bioactive components in the common known as Kalme. This is the systematic position of the Kalme. The leaves of the Kalme are dark in color, like and simple, opposite and decussate means the leaf is alternate like this way and this way. The leaves of Kalme have a dark stomata leaf, leaves lower epidermis, glandular and non-glandular trichomes. Fairly large polytrichs, columnar plast cells, parenchyma and midrib beneath the epidermis, spongy parenchyma cells, vascular bundles of lignified spiral, scleriform and reticulata xylem vessels in the upper parts and lignified phloem in the lower parts, small axicular calcium oxalate crystals, elevated small waxy appearance seen in the petioles of the leaves, dense pollen chyma in at the corner of the stem, a layer of the thick wall, endodermis cell and parenchyma contain chloroplasts. Cultivation and distribution, mainly this is a cultivated in the Southeast Asia and India. This is a sown in the February to March, April, and flowering is November, December, and maturity in the March, April. At the flowering stage, the chemical is the maximum at this stage. Some honey is seen. Mainly, this calmec plant is grown in those soils, barren land, and like a metallic residue is found, then this plant is grown very good. And those plants where they submerge, this plant not grow easily, like as a east part of India. Therapeutic use. Calmec is reported in 26 Ayurvedic formulations as evidences from Indian pharmacopoeia. While in traditional Chinese medicine, it is an important food property. Herbs used to relieve body heat in fever. The species is well explored, therapeutic, and effectively used is a immunization and for asthma, norovirus, bile dysentery, and dyspepsia, blood purification, pyrogenitis, fever, losses of scalpel hair, snakes bites, myocardia, eczema, common cold, diabetes, respiration tract infection, jaundice, among others. The species also possess anti-leprogenic, anti-typhoid, anti-snakes, venom, anti-platelet aggregation, and anti-HIV, anti-malaria, anti-fertility, anti-inflammatory, and anti-paralytic properties. Next time, bio-effective of the species against phytopathogenic like different species of bacteria, Irmina, Cartova, Pseudomonas, Marginella, P. serenia, P. aeruginous, and Xanthomonas, Campestris, fungus, Acromonium, Strychnum, Alternaria, alternata, Aspergillus flavus, Bioplevis, Viper, Clostridium, Herbarium, Curuvaria, Inocta, Fusarium, Oxysporum, Penicillium, Expansum, Rhizotina, Sonai, Triesprola, Selina, and Stilobum Medis. Was noted from the methylate 95%, chloroform 80%, and hexa 65% extract. Ethylic effect of the leaves. To conclude, this other significant therapeutic use. Like as a dendrophyllia is found to be active against pneumonia, type of tuberculosis, tuberculosis meningitis, and acute pleuropheritic intra-intervascular intravenous injection of the herbs were reported to be effective in the thermogenous obliterata, especially for heterotoxic type. 10 cases of viper bites were reportedly cured in 3 to 5 days by the compound formerly contained Calmag as the chief constituent. Different disease may be this is used. Conclusion, Calmag is a dietrogenoid lactone having a variety of pharmacological effect, especially in Ayurveda, Yunani, Siddha and traditional Chinese medicine. This herb has been revered for treating infection, disease and highly regarded as having preventive effect against ailments like liver damage, hypoglycemia, dysentery, cancer, pulmonary, tuberculosis as acute and common cold, flu, myocardia, infection, inflammation, blood clotting, etc. It has been toxic effect by the it found unsafe during the pregnancy. Besides a great number of pharmaceutical used andrography flights has some side effect like nausea, vomiting, losses of appetite, which can only be seen upon overdose. Therefore, research may be further be undertaken to develop two potent formulation consist of Calmag and its isolate molecules andrographies by making use of novel herbal drug delivery systems like microproteins. Any query and suggestion? Thank you, Bala.
Respected dignitaries on the dais, my friends, good evening to all of you. Myself, Dr. Swagata Tavre, PG scholar of Gujarat Ayurveda University, going to present my work entitled Harvesting of Ashwagandha, that is Vidhanya Somnifera according to Rina Cycles. Introduction. Acharya Charaka emphatically describes the technical excellence in the field of pharmacognosy, pharmaceutics, with the quotation idam eva prakruti eva gunam eva prabhavam asmin deshe jatam asmin ruto. Here evam rutu refers to seasons for collection of drugs, which plays an important role in the field of drug research. Drug becomes capable of producing maximum therapeutic effects when their potency is augmented by deshe sampat, kala sampat, guna sampat and bhajan sampat. Here kala sampat means collecting of the plant in appropriate season. Proper harvesting techniques are useful to preserve the active principles among medicinal plants. Aim and objectives: to assess the influence of season on the active principles of ashwagandha root and quantification of active principles for evaluating the influence of lunar cycles in two different seasons. Collection of part use. Charaka has explained to collect root in Grishma and Shishir Ritu, where Acharya Chakrapani has commented that Ushna Viryatmak drug should be collected in Grishma and Shita Viryatmak in Shishir Ritu. Modern concept of lunar. As per modern science, the changes in climate and its effect on bodies ultimately governed by lunar cycles. The law of gravitation proved by Isaac Newton states that tides are affected by gravitational pull of moon. Here, with more water being drawn up into soil due to full moon, thus causes seeds to sprout and fast, and plant grows vigorously at optimum rate due to increased hydration. Thus, yield is maximum. Laboratory experiments carried out on lunar. Minimum 0.1 lux light is required for photoperiodism, whereas the light on full moon is 0.3 lux, that is 3 times greater. Experimental study, cultivation and collection of ashwagandha, 14 small crops of ashwagandha of average size of 10 cm were collected and planted in IPGTRA campus. The rituals as per classics are followed. This is cultivation. Time schedule for collection. The study is divided into two groups, group A and group B. In group A, in Shishir Ritu, 4 samples are collected on Magh Amavasya, Magh Purnima, Phalgun Amavasya and Phalgun Purnima. And in group B, that is in Grishma Ritu, 4 samples are collected, that is on Jeshta Amavasya, Jeshta Purnima, Ashad Amavasya and Ashad Purnima. The sunrise time has been taken into consideration and plants were collected within 1 hour after sunrise so as to keep time variable constant. Anthropometrical variation. The parameters studied are length of the plant, length of the root, weight of root, number of rootlets, diameter of cross section of root and pith. Parameters of Shishir Ritu, the length of plant, root, all the parameters are progressively increasing, but in Phalgun Purnima, all highest parameter size has been observed among Grishma Ritu. among Shishi Rutu. In Grishma Rutu, the highest parameter size was observed in Ashar Purnima, that is, the plant length was 115 cm and root weight was 46 gram, and difference in cross section of diameter of root and pith was 0.5 cm. This is variation in diameter of root and pith in Shishi Rutu. All the anthropometrical parameters were statistically analyzed by PCA, that is principal component analysis. This is basically on the basis of anthropometrical characters. In Phalgun Amavasya and Phalgun Purnima samples, growth of plant was seen in laterally. The gain in root weight was from Magh Amavasya to Magh Purnima was 0.414 gram. That is, from Magh Amavasya to Phalgun Amavasya, it has been doubled. From Magh Amavasya to Phalgun Purnima, it has been tripled. From Magh Amavasya to Jyeshtha Purnima, it has got 4 times. And from Magh Amavasya to Ashadha Purnima, it was got 6 times increase in root weight. Phytochemical analysis, materials and method. The root powder was studied on the basis of physiochemical parameters and phytochemical parameters, in which total phenolic content, flavonoid content, free sugar estimation was done, and UV vision analysis spectroscopy within the range of 180 to 2500 was studied. Comparison of loss on drying. Maximum loss on drying was found in Purnima samples, and being maximum being in Ashar Purnima, that is 54.0213%. Acceptive values. Maximum acceptive values were found in Phalgun Purnima in Shishir Rutu samples, and maximum acceptive values of total phenolic content, flavonoid and carbohydrate content was found in Ashadha Purnima, and amongst both group, that is in Shishir and Grishma, maximum extractive values are found in Ashadha Purnima Rutu. Therefore, Ashwagandha being Ushna Viryatmak should be collected in Grishma Rutu. PCA on the basis of phenolic flavonoid content were raised in the plant. Total carbohydrate content, carbohydrate from structural component, alcoholic carbohydrate extract, the maximum values are found in Ashadha Purnima. Thus, there is definitely influence of lunar on the functional groups of plants. UV vision spectroscopy, this is a UV vision graph. This is spectrum. After analyzing 2300 points, there were total 9 points where the all the samples shows discrimination from each other. These are 9 points. These 9 points and their functional groups are shown, as we shown on the slide. These functional groups are basically antioxidant free radical scavenger, forms a molecular feature of the proteins, confers the structural rigidity. All these can be termed under the term that is secondary metabolite, which plays a major role in adaptation of plants to changing environment and in overcoming stress constraints. The study confirms that the plant parts collected according to lunar cycles can influence the final yield of the active principles of the herbs. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Sagar. Namaskar. My title is Comparative Estimation of Total Phenolic Content and GCMS Studies on Garcinia Indica Based Polyherbal Cow Urine Distillate and Aqueous Distillate. The world is getting panicked due to number of diseases like cancer, diabetes, aging, multiple disorgan failure. Now, we have to think, what is the problem behind these diseases? Why people are suffering from so many diseases? It has been established that oxidative stress is among the major causative factor behind all these diseases. And who is responsible for this oxidative stress? Reactive oxygen species, ROS, are responsible for this oxidative stress. No doubt, reactive oxygen species are fully inactivated by intrinsic cellular and extracellular antioxidant defense system, but an imbalance between the neutralization and generation of reactive oxygen species causes oxidative stress. This balance between the reactive oxygen species and antioxidative defense system is very important. When there is balance between ROS and antioxidative defense system, there is no problem. But when the reactive oxygen species, the oxidative stress causes so many diseases like cancer, lifestyle related diseases, immune disorders and aging. Now, what is the solution for this oxidative stress or for this reactive oxygen species? Antioxidants are the solution for this oxidative stress. although body's antioxidant system is able to arrest this reactive oxygen species, but the prolonged exposure to xenobiotics and infection overtake the antioxidant defense system and cause irreversible oxidative damage to body. Under such conditions of prolonged oxidative stress, an exogenous supply of antioxidant is necessary. But the real solution is not to supply the exogenous antioxidants, because the researches over the year have proved that synthetic antioxidants are associated with so many toxicities. So the real solution is natural antioxidants, and we have to think for Ayurveda. Now we have prepared one antioxidant formulation using five herbs and cow urine. The importance of cow urine has been described in Ayurveda in the treatment of so many diseases. Indigenous cow is mobile medical dispensary. Cow urine is being used in preparation of Ayurvedic medicine in the form of ingredient or as a detoxifying material or as a potency enhancer, and our scientists have received a US patent for its various activities like immunomodulatory activity, bioenhancer activity and anti-cancer activity. We have developed one antioxidant formulation using Garcinia indica, Curcuma longa, Gingiber officinale, Osimum sanctum, Mentha arvensis and urine of indigenous cow. The work started with standardization. Standardization of all the herbal material has been done by with the help of Ayurvedic pharmacopoeia. But for standards of cow urine, we have analyzed 200 morning samples of Gir cow within 2 years, and we have developed our own standards. For standardization of cow urine, we have used parameters such as general observation, weight per ml, total solid, conductivity in proportion to total solid, pH, alkalinity, alkaline equivalence, total phenolic assay, phenol per gram of total solid, phenol in distillate means gomutra arg, nitrogen estimation and TLC, test for heavy metals, microbial count. We have also informed Dr. Abhimanyu Kumarji to incorporate this data in Ayurvedic pharmacopoeia. Now, methodology of this formulation: measured quantity of 4 herbs except Garcinia indica were swirled individually with fresh cow urine, and the measured quantity of Garcinia indica was soaked in cow urine and water for 24 hours for proper extraction, and the juices were extracted by the same procedure. Measured quantity of all the 5 herbal juices were mixed in appropriate proportion, and the mixed juices in cow urine and water separately were concentrated to 50% by Bukki's Rota evaporator to get polyherbal cow urine distillate and polyherbal aqueous distillate. In this way, we have prepared 2 types of distillate using cow urine and using water separately. Now, this is experimental work that we have carried out. Estimation of total phenolic content. This was determined by using Foline Kiokaltz method spectrophotometrically. GCMS studies, methanolic extract of both the distillates were subjected for GCMS to identify various biochemical compounds present in those distillates. These are the results. Total phenolic content. Here you can see the total phenolic content of polyherbal cow urine distillate is approximately double as that of polyherbal aqueous distillate. These are the results of GCMS study. 55 important biochemically active compounds have been identified in cow urine based polyherbal formulation, whereas only 32 compounds are available in distilled water or aqueous based polyherbal formulation. Evaluation of antioxidant status. We have also evaluated antioxidant status of both the cow urine based distillate and water based distillate. For this estimation, we have used total antioxidant capacity assay kit of BioVision company that we have imported from Germany. These are the important results. We have also carried out total antioxidant status of popular allopathic drug. and the result was 10.27 trolox equivalent only. Whereas the total antioxidant status of cow urine based polyherbal formulation was 128 trolox equivalent. The total antioxidant status of aqueous distillate using same herb was 77.60. And the total antioxidant status of cow urine alone was 46.43%. That is, it is for the antioxidant status of cow urine alone is 4 times than allopathic drug, and our formulation is having antioxidant status 14 times more. Conclusion: the antioxidant status of cow urine based polyherbal formulation is very high as compared to distilled water based formulation. The total phenolic content of cow urine based polyherbal formulation is significantly more as compared to aqueous based formulation. 55 biochemically active compounds have been identified in polyherbal cow urine distillate, whereas only 33 compounds have been identified in same formulation prepared with distilled water. And several important compounds are absent in aqueous based formulation, and the quantity was also less. So the results imply that cow urine based polyherbal product is potential source of natural antioxidant, total phenolic compound and several other phytochemicals which have free radical scavenging activity and might be useful for hepato, cyto, radio protection as well as reducing oxidative stress in many pathological conditions. Vande Gau Matram, Vande Ayurveda.
Thank you, Dr. Sangani. Very nice presentation. Any question on this paper?
Professor B.K. Joshi, sir. Professor B.K. Jaisingh, sir. And other dignitaries, my dear friends. The presentation overall is very good. Since I represent from the industry area, and we are almost marketing more than 400 products, more in Kerala and across India. I think two things are very much important. One is, from where do we collect the drivias or drugs? It is very much important because the active ingredients in drugs collected from different regions are different, and also pesticide content, microbial content and heavy metals. These are big issues when it comes to a practical approach or preparing medicines to sell. And another one important thing is anivanam is also very much important. So while administering, we need to have a clear understanding about anivanam. Other than that, definitely there is some importance in the seasonal collection also. I think most of the presenters had given a fairly, done it very fairly in a good way. I think certain small issues are there. I think it can be neglected. With these words, I conclude. I appreciate all the presenters. All the best. Thank you.
Dr. Srinivas Singh, he has reached late, so then he is permitted to speak on his paper for 5 minutes. So, Dr. Singh.
respected dignitaries and dais of the dais, ladies and gentlemen. मैं थोड़ा हिंदी में बोलूंगा ताकि जल्दी जल्दी बोल सकूं. स्टेप्स टू बी टेकन फॉर चिनोपाड रिवोल्यूशन. मैं कुछ चिनोपाड्स दिखाऊंगा. ये आयुर्वेदिक टेक्स्ट में वास्तु खास करके जो ये जुनिपर जी के भाव प्रकाश में घंटू में मिलेगा वो बथुआ ही है जिसको हिंदी में बथुआ या बथुआ कहते हैं. और ये वास्तव में वीड है, मेडिसिनल वीड है और किसानों के लिए तो घाटा करता है लेकिन इसको फसल भी बनाया जा सकता है. और ये वर्मीफ्यूज डीवर्मिंग के लिए इस्तेमाल होता है और आयरन रिच होने के कारण रक्तवर्धक भी है और हीमोग्लोबिन कंटेंट बढ़ा देता है. पुअर पीपुल के लिए अच्छा है, अनार से अच्छा कहिए. और यही सीजन है रबी का जब इलाटा पुअर पीपुल रूरल एरिया से कलेक्ट करते हैं खास करके बहुत सारे रबी क्रॉप फील्ड से. और मैं बताना चाहूँगा गुड एग्रीकल्चरल प्रैक्टिसेस के बारे में. और हम सोच रहे थे कि न बोले अब बथुआ पे लेकिन ये पौधा अर्ली आ गया और हमको बाध्य किया कि अब नहीं और बोलिए. तो ये चिनोपाड चिनोपोडियेसी फैमिली के मेंबर्स हैं और ये चिनोपोडियम एल्बम वीड है, मेडिसिनल भी है. और चिनोपोडियम एम्ब्रोसियाडिस जिसे होम्योपैथ में सिना देते होंगे डीवर्मिंग के लिए तो यही होता है. और चिनोपोडियम के इम्प्रूव्ड वेराइटीज की ज़रूरत है ताकि बहुत ज़्यादा मात्रा में चिनोपोडियम पैदा हो सके. हमारा ऑब्जेक्टिव था एक्सप्लोर कलेक्ट इवेलुएट आइडेंटिफाई एंड आइडेंटिफाई द प्रॉमिसिंग चिनोपाड्स एक्सप्लोर एंड हाईलाइट देयर पोटेंशियल्स एंड सजेस्ट इफेक्टिव स्टेप्स फॉर एक्सटेंशन पॉपुलराइजेशन एडॉप्शन ऑफ प्रूवन चिनोपाड्स लीडिंग टू चिनोपाड रिवोल्यूशन. वी कलेक्टेड अबाउट 12 टू 13 चिनोपाड्स फ्रॉम ईस्टर्न यूपी सेंट्रल यूपी एंड वेस्टर्न यूपी एंड वी ऑल्सो प्रोक्योर्ड 10 एग्जोटिक्स फ्रॉम नेशनल ब्यूरो ऑफ प्लांट जेनेटिक रिसोर्सेज नई दिल्ली. वी इवेल्युएटेड देम फॉर यील्ड हाई यील्ड पोटेंशियल क्रॉप एंड कलर पोटेंशियल एक्सेट्रा. वी ऑल्सो इवेल्युएटेड देम फॉर क्रॉप कंपेटेबिलिटी सेलेक्टेड फॉर लॉन्गर वेजिटेटिव फेज to ensure almost year round supply of green vegetables. Among indigenous ones, Chinopodium dabanga is early season crop. Chinopodium luna, it is very tender. It has higher tender portion compared to harder portion. Chinopodium sanus, late variety, and Chinopodium siam, very late variety. All 10 exotic chinopods are of longer duration, so they will enhance the year-round supply of green herbs. For chinopod revolution, we need to take steps for seed production, distribution, popularization, especially in multi-story cropping, they can make middle canopy. And we need to harness their all potentials, medicinal, yield, high potential, craft, color, crop, compatibility. They can be used as live and dead standard to support many climber crops. And they can be used as mulch, green manure, weed control potential. थोड़ा दिखा दूँ वो ये चिनोपोडियम दबंगा है, बहुत नरम होता है. मुन्ना चिनोपोडियम मुन्ना ये देवरिया के गांव से इकट्ठा किया गया है, एक स्टूडेंट ने इकट्ठा किया. फिर इस टेंडर पोर्शन इसमें बहुत ज़्यादा है. ये देखिए इसके इतना बड़ा हो जाएगा हम शुरू में नहीं सोचे थे, बहुत बड़ा होता है. और गरीबों के लिए तो कहीं दो चार महीने खाना देता है. ये देखिए इसमें क्राफ्ट पोटेंशियल बहुत ज़्यादा है. ये एग्जोटिक वाले लंगर ड्यूरेशन के हैं और ये कांग्रेस ग्रास को एकदम कंट्रोल कर देगा 95%. हम तो कहेंगे कि
कांग्रेस ग्रास फ्री इंडिया बनाने के प्रयास करिए आप लोग। तीन वीड हैं जो पार्थेनियम, ये लंटाना और यूपेटोरियम बहुत नाश करते हैं अपने देश का, तो ये कांग्रेस को, कांग्रेस ग्रास को तो हम कंट्रोल कर देंगे इससे। पल्स की कमी है, पल्स दलहन दलहन की कमी है, तो ये राजमा की सुल्तान वैरायटी है जो एक ही सीजन में दो क्रॉप ले सकते हैं और इससे इंटरक्रॉपिंग कर सकते हैं, तो दलहन की समस्या कम कर देगा। और ये देखिए आधी आबादी को खुश कर देने वाला क्राफ्ट बनेगा चिनोपोडियम श्याम के स्टेम से, और वॉकिंग स्टिक भी बनता है, ये देखिए कलर भी बनेगा होली के लिए, बहुत अच्छा कलर बनेगा। और फूड एडिटिव्स आप लोग फूड में और मेडिसिन में मिला सकते हैं। ये लाल वाला चिनोपोडियम दबंगा है, हरा वाला चिनोपोडियम श्याम है। कंक्लूजन, ताल टाइप 20 चिनो पार्ट्स में बहुत सारा पोटेंशियल है, आप इतना हार्नेस कर सकते हैं। ये देखिए ये प्रेसिडेंट के स्टेट से है, ये दोनों चिनोपोडियम इसी ईयर पिछले सीजन और इस सीजन में भी होंगे, ये दिखाने के लिए हैं। भगवान करे आप सब लोग मिलके पूरे इंडियंस को खाने के लिए पहुँचाएँ। और बैलेंस डाइट, यही नहीं कि सिर्फ चिनोपोडियम है, ये बहुरूपिया चिनोपोडियम एल्बम है, बहुत पॉलीमॉर्फिक है, ठीक है। तो देखिए चिनोपोडियम श्याम इसका वो क्राफ्ट पोटेंशियल है, और बहुत देखिए चिनोपोडियम के नाम पे नदियों का नाम भी है, जिसे देवरिया रुद्रपुर में बथुआ नाला है, बिहार नॉर्थ बिहार में दो बथुआ बाजार है, ये काठमांडू में चिनोपोडियम थोड़ा ठंडा इलाका है इसलिए लॉन्गर वेजिटेटिव फेज होता है, हरा रहता है। और क्लाइंबर का पे सपोर्ट के लिए राजमा, पोल टाइप राजमा के सपोर्ट के लिए, और आधे आबादी को खुश करो, रंग भी भरो और आर्नामेंटल सारनाथ भी। थैंक यू,
थैंक यू डॉक्टर सिंह। सिंह साहब तो लास्ट में आके खाना भी खिलाए, रंग होली भी खिलाए, तो मेनी मेनी थैंक्स। तो आई ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ द ऑर्गेनाइजर्स आई थैंक ऑल द स्पीकर्स फॉर देयर नाइस प्रेजेंटेशन, एंड आई थैंक द ऑडियंस दैट फॉर पेशेंस हियरिंग। सो नाउ आई मूव द माइक टू द ऑर्गेनाइजर्स। ऑर्गेनाइजर्स प्लीज। डॉक्टर भास्कर, हेलो, शोभा, श्वेता पाटिल,
हिल जाओ हिल जाओ हिल जाओ आगे। Thank you, sir.
Jyoti Nanda.
Jyoti
Nanda.
बराबर वाले होने वाले
श्रीनिवास सिंह मिस्टर ब्रजेश प्रताप डॉक्टर स्वागता जय किशोर थैंक यू वेरी मच आई फॉर्मली थैंक्स अवर चेयरपर्सन एंड द को चेयरपर्सन फॉर देयर प्रेजेंस एंड दे हैव ग्रेस्ड द ओकेजन आई थैंक ऑल द पार्टिसिपेंट्स एंड द ऑर्गेनाइजर्स टू मेक दिस प्रोग्राम अ सक्सेस थैंक यू वेरी मच